Hey folks, it's Patrick here, and welcome back to my channel. In this video, we're talking about ageism in the queer community. The reason I'm doing this video now is because I recently experienced ageism, or at least I got triggered by the thought of it. Let me set the scene for you.
There's this new gay talk show that's coming out soon. It's filming here in Toronto. It's called One Queen, Five Queers, and it's hosted and produced by the one, the only, Brooklyn Heights, the Queen of the North. Remember she came out on point in that mummy costume on Drag Race? For reference for this new show, if you know the show One Girl, Five Gays, it's that but with a drag. Just between us, something like a gay talk show where a queen sits around with a bunch of people from the LGBTQ2+ community chatting about the gay experience is completely in my wheelhouse. This is perfect for me. I am ready for it. Now, today's community, as you know, is more diverse than ever. So me, being a cisgender white gay male, it might not be as exciting a prospect as, say, a biracial, gender nonconforming, two-spirited individual. But you know what? I naively thought that my age was gonna be my trump card. I have so much experience under my belt, so much perspective to give, and so many stories to share. So I'm reading the criteria for the show in the email that I received as for part of the audition process, and that's when I see it. Looking for people between the ages of 20 and 40. My heart just sank. I was like, really? This amazing opportunity is not even an option for me because I'm a few years over this cutoff date. And then I thought, why 40? That seems really young. And then I realized the show is probably geared towards kids and the demographic they're going for skews young. But then I thought, so what? Are you saying that young people can only watch other young people on TV? Because if that's the case, then where's the diversity? You want different genders, you want different races, but oh my God, nobody over 40, please. That's where I draw the line. Hey, I want to jump in for a second and say, if you're liking this video, why not give me a thumbs up so I know you do. Okay, back to the video. If they really want to have a diverse discussion about the LGBTQ2+ experience on that show, that would include somebody over 40, wouldn't it? So you know what I did? I applied anyway. Oh yeah! I know, I'm a badass, right? I'm so not a badass. So I thought, okay, maybe the age cutoff that they put there is more like a suggestion. I sent in the audition video like they asked, and eventually I got a generic email. Thank you for auditioning, but unfortunately, blah, blah, blah. Now I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, Patrick, you're lashing out because you weren't chosen, and it's not because you're over 40, it's because they didn't want you. Get over it, you suck. And you know what? Maybe you're right. Maybe I do suck. I know I suck. Oh, that's a different video. Okay, but you're right. Maybe I wasn't the great fit for the show that I thought I was going to be. And that's fine. But the fact that I felt like I had to lie about my age to get on a show that is about diversity feels weird. It's really a scourge on our culture, the way that we discredit and throw away anyone over a certain age. One of my very guilty pleasures, and I call it a guilty pleasure because people make fun of it all the time, is watching Coronation Street out of the UK. If you haven't heard of it, check it out. They aren't afraid to show what real life looks like. Some of the characters are old. You have characters on that show in their 70s and 80s with starring roles and important storylines. And you know what that does to an audience that's watching that program? It normalizes and embraces the fact that older people have lives. They have feelings. They matter. Let's take Madonna as an example. This woman was pushing buttons from the get-go. And we lapped it up. We cheered her on from the sidelines because, you know, it's safer on the sidelines. And we watched her at least try to change how society sees those topics. Well, fast forward, the material girl is in her 60s. Do I want to see her rubbing her vajayjay and humping the ground? Not really. Do I look at some of the pictures she posts and cringe because she went too far with like facial fillers? Yes. But it's easy for me to sit here and criticize somebody who's out there and fighting the good fight. But then I realized she has to do that. The pendulum is so far in the other direction, meaning people in our community and our hetero female counterparts are basically tossed aside after 40. And sure, it's changing slowly. We see movies with an older female cast like Diane Keaton and Candace Bergen. Bergen. It's baby steps. And then here's Madonna pushing things so far and so hard the other way, pushing sexuality over 60 in your face, whether you like it or not. It's polarizing. But that's her whole shtick. And frankly, if her wearing thigh-high boots and swinging around a pole is what it takes to try to convince people that women and members of our community are sexual beings and still alive and still matter, well, then so be it. The tragedy for me is that so many members of the LGBTQ2+ community die so young, either from drug overdoses, disease, hate crimes, suicide. Anyone who makes it to a milestone like 50 or 60 or 70 or 80, that should be celebrated. We should hold these people up. It means they made it through this minefield that we call life. Oh, you know what a perfect example is? Queer as Folk. They're doing a reboot, if you haven't heard. It's coming back, but with a new cast, because the original cast are now all over 40. And who wants to watch a bunch of gay guys over 40 navigate their lives, right? Ha ha! Wrong. Do you know how many comments and messages I've seen on message boards and stuff from original fans of the show who are dying to know what happened to the original cast members of Queer as Folk? I would love to watch that. Now, I'm not putting all of this on poor little Brooklyn Heights. She probably doesn't even know that there was a 40-year-old cutoff for the show. And I will absolutely be watching One Queen, Five Queers when it comes out. It's just that I got a bit triggered by the audition process and I needed to unpack that issue with you guys. So, thank you for listening. I guess it's up to me to go out there and create my own show, like Nia Vardalos when she made My Big Fat Greek Wedding. And I want to know, have you experienced anything like what I'm talking about here? Let me know in the comments below. And I need to take a minute, this is so exciting, to welcome my very first patron, David! To check out the different membership levels, just go to the link in the description below. And don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell for notifications of new videos. And I will see you in the next video. Mwah!